Let's take a look at the tail of the tape for Canelo Alvarez and Kermit Cintron from Mexico City. Alvarez at 21 years of age, Cintron at 32. Height advantage for Cintron by 3 inches at 5'11". Slight reach advantage for Cintron. And both fighters made 154 pounds easily. No issues with weight coming into the fight tonight. So we are getting set for the main event from Mexico City. Canelo Alvarez making the third defense of his junior middleweight championship against former welterweight champion Kermit Cintron. Enthusiastic crowd in Mexico City and big home crowd advantage. Fight taking place in a bull ring in Mexico City. So I would think for Cintron, he's got to be able to steady the tide early, Max.
Yeah, like dropping Canelo wouldn't hurt if you're Cintron. Cintron was what used to be a really good puncher at 147 pounds, has not shown the same power at 54 so far, though he claims to be trying to settle up down on his punches a little bit more. Sit down on him, as they say.
He's been stopped twice by Antonio Margarito, battered in both of those fights.
Pre-Margarito getting caught against Mosley with the hand wraps, it should be mentioned.
Right, and as Cintron told us, I'd never been hit like that before. But he's coming off again win against Antoine Smith. He's got Ronnie Shields in his corner. Roy, this is a tough task on the road like this.
Yeah, it's a very tough task, but you got to give him credit, too. He's made a lot of changes. He went from being a power puncher to a puncher who throws a lot more punches.
You know, we talked to him this morning, and he said he feels fine. You know, he had the 14-month layoff, which he said, I had to take care of some personal stuff. It was a mistake to have that long a layoff, but he feels rejuvenated now.
Well, he came off the long layoff against Molina, who turns out to be a pretty damn good fighter, got out-hustled, made sure not to get out-hustled in his next fight, and now needs to find a happy medium, right? He needs to maybe not throw 130 punches around, maybe throw half that number, and sit down on them and make them count more, but also not get out-hustled and be lethargic as he was against Molina.
You know, and he hustled in his last fight against Antoine Smith back in August. Set a CompuBox record for the 154-pound weight class. In that fight in round number one, he threw 98 jabs just in that first round, so he was busy. And
I'd like to see some hooks and right hands behind those jabs.
He averaged 113 punches thrown per round. So we're waiting for Kermit Cintron to make his way out of his locker room in Atlantic, in Mexico City. And now I think Kermit is just about ready to go. And we should note that we are taking the feed from Mexican television. They are showing some of the highlights of Kermit Cintron.
Cintron, a really good athlete. Not a natural boxer, a made boxer. And maybe that's hurt him in his career a little bit. He's not boxed his entire life, but he's very athletic, he's quick, he has power in both hands. Roy, and I think that he learned a fair amount of boxing skills as a pro.
Yeah, I think he learned a lot of boxing skills as a pro because when he first came on the scene, he was known as one hell of a puncher.
2006 is when he won the vacant welterweight belt with a fifth round stoppage of Mark Suarez, knocked out Walter Matisse. Knocked off Jose Feliciano. Then he lost in the sixth round, knocked out by Antonio Margarito, in which he lost his title. Had a good win against Alfredo Angulo, as Roy referred to earlier.
Really good win. Outboxed him and won on points at a time where Angulo was considered not unbeatable, but certainly an up-and-comer who was going to be tough for even the veterans to beat, and Cintron pulled it off.
And there is Kermit Cintron in the ring, 32 years of age, born in Puerto Rico, lives in Reading, Pennsylvania, fighting out of Houston, Texas, under the guidance of trainer Ronnie Shields. He said, look, Alvarez is a good, young, hungry fighter, just like I was. I need to be more aggressive than he's going to be. But I feel great right now, but I'm better than I was when I stepped into the ring the night I fought Angulo. We're going to find out. He was very relaxed when we spoke to him today, as relaxed as I can remember in a fighter meeting. Maybe that's because he had already made the weight.
As Roy mentioned, though, he ain't going to be winning any close rounds tonight. The judges' scorecards, I don't think.
Y su oponente en la esquina roja, el orgullo de México, Saul Canelo Alvarez.
Born in in Guadalajara, fights out of Guadalajara, one of the big ratings and ticket sellers in all of Mexico, Canelo Alvarez.
Almost as though the crowd really wants him to win, Bob. This is no neutral. I mean, he was a YouTube sensation here in this country as he was packing 10,000 fans into arenas in Mexico before anyone on American television knew who he was.
Well, his life's changed a lot over the last year and a half. He used to ride the bus when he went to the gym. Now he rides in an Escalade. Bought a new house in the suburban part of Guadalajara. And he's just 21. He turned 21 back on July the 18th. So both fighters have made their way into the ring as Alvarez gets set to defend his junior middleweight championship for the third time. Broken out all the stops in Mexico City with pyrotechnics. And there's the belt that's at stake tonight. Alvarez's share of the junior middleweight championship. Fight taking place in the bull ring in Mexico City. Pretty much standard order of business for Alvarez. You know, one of the things, Max, that you talked to him about was the fact that Julio Cesar Chavez Jr., the other big name in Mexico's boxing scene as far as the young guys, he had an impressive win. And we asked Alvarez, he said, I'm getting a little tired of always having to answer questions about Chavez, but he knows it's inevitable.
Well, there's only one way to stop answering those questions. That goes for the both of them as you get in the ring together. Alvarez, only 21 years old. Cintron earned this shot by looking less than great in his last couple fights, because the idea with Alvarez is he's such a ticket seller and he is talented, and he's a baby, really, 21. They don't want to get him bumped off before he reaches the elite. But the sense from Cintron is he's not quite there yet, and the hope is that Alvarez has taken him lightly, at least from the Cintron camp.
Well, it works in Alvarez's favor if Cintron goes out and tries to box like he's been doing lately, because boxing, he's not a danger at all to Alvarez, especially being in Mexico. But if he goes back to that puncher's mentality that he used to have, Alvarez could have a problem.
And we could have something special tonight if he does that.
Most definitely.
Probably the longest I can ever remember the headliners in the ring waiting for the introductions. So we're just about set for the main event. Canelo Alvarez and Kermit Cintron. As we get set to turn things over to our ring announcer for the evening, Joe Martinez.
Dos asaltos por el título CMB peso super welter. And now, ladies and gentlemen, here at the Plaza Toros here in Mexico City, Mexico, it is time for the main event of the evening. 12 rounds scheduled for the WBC light middleweight championship of the world. Puerto Rico contra Mexico. Presentado por, brought to you by Oscar de la Hoya's Golden Boy Promotions y Canelo Promotions. Patrocinada por, sponsored by Corona en el centro del ring, Tequila Don Ramon y Tabasco. Sancionada por la Comisión de Box del Distrito Federal, Supervisor de CMB, the WBC Supervisor in Attendance, Mike George, y el Presidente Supervisor de CMB, the WBC President in Attendance, José Suleiman. Los tres jueces por este combate, the three judges scoring this bout at ringside, de los Estados Unidos, Chris Tellez, de Canadá, Robert Trapper, y también de Canadá, David Bilocerkowec. El referee encargado de los servicios de ring, the referee in charge of the action when the bell rings, from Panama, Hector Afu. Y ahora, damas y caballeros, los jueces están listos, los peleadores están listos. Si están listos, mexicanos, dile al mundo. Presentar primero la esquina azul, con los pantaloncillos negro, can azul y rojo, y un peso, 69 kilos, 900 gramos. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black trim with the colors of Puerto Rico, red, white, and blue, he weighed in officially 154 pounds. Su record excelente con 33 victorias, 28 ganadas por knockout, solamente 4 derrotas y un empate. His professional record stands 33 victories, including 28 knockout wins, just 4 defeats and 1 bout even. De Houston, Texas, de los Estados Unidos, nacido de Carolina, Puerto Rico, el ex campeón OMB y FBI peso welter. Here is the former WBO, IBF welterweight champion, el retador, the challenger, Kermit the Killer Cintron. Y su oponente en la esquina roja, con los pantaloncillos blanco con negro y un peso, 69 kilos, 900 gramos. His opponent fighting out of the red corner, wears tonight white trunks trimmed in black and weighed in also 154 ready pounds. Su record perfecto con 38 victorias, 28 ganadas por nocaut, 0 derrotas y un empate. His professional record stands perfect at 38 victories, no defeats, 1 bout even and 28 wins coming by way of knockout. Presentando el hijo de Guadalajara, Jalisco, México, el campeón mundial CMB peso super welter. Here is the undefeated WBC light middleweight champion of the world, Saul Canelo Alvarez. Otra vez el árbitro. Once again, your referee in charge, Hector Afu.
Chavez Jr. looked like he made real strides against Peter Manfredo last week. Canelo Alvarez's turn right now.
It's kind of fun, the fact that they fight in close time frame to each other, so we can do the instant analysis and comparison of who looks better or who looked more dominant. So he gets set for the start of round number one between Alvarez and Cintron. Let's see if Cintron can work at a steady pace and put pressure on Alvarez.
He looks very relaxed early.
When we asked Alvarez sort of what the game plan was this morning, he said, look, I don't feel him out in the first round, just get a sense. I'm gonna look to counterpunch, I know that, but sort of then decide which plan we need to enact once round two begins. 5 first round knockouts for Alvarez, 7 for Cintron.
I'm impressed to see how either one of them reacts to the other one's power punches.
Cintron's been down 6 times in his career. 5 times to Antonio Margarito, once to Sergio Martinez. Good left hand by Alvarez.
Looked like he took that pretty good. But he better hurry up and hit Alvarez back with something hard to get some respect. Because if he don't, he doesn't want Alvarez to come at him full-fledged.
One of the problems is that even though Cintron's a good athlete, he didn't start boxing until he was 19. Alvarez since he was 13. And so Roy, in exchanges, even though Cintron's athletic, Alvarez's shots may land first.
Most definitely.
This is the 244th professional round for Alvarez, the 193rd professional round for Cintron. Cintron was an outstanding wrestler in the Reading, Pennsylvania area. In fact, went to college to wrestle at Thaddeus Stevens College of Technology, ranked 10th nationally, but the school dropped it. He dropped out because he didn't have money to stay in school. His uncle, who he lived with in Reading, Benjamin Serrano, was a boxer, and he tried it and fell in love with it. But that's why he had the late start.
Roy, there's debate about the extent of Canelo's power. To me, it looks like he's heavy-handed. What do you think of his power?
I think he's very heavy-handed. And to me, the same thing he's saying about Cintron is the same thing I think about Chavez. Chavez Jr. didn't have a real amateur career. He just turned professional. This kid been fighting amateur since he was 13. So I think Chavez has more ground to cover than does Alvarez.
In terms of his power, I don't know, it just, he lands with a thud every time he seems to throw Alvarez.
Very strong punches. Like I said earlier, when the first few times we've seen him, I was like, this kid is different because he's a Mexican who really can punch. I mean, a real puncher at 154 pounds.
There's the bell to end round number one.
Sit down. That was a good feel that round. All right.
Breathe, breathe. Some water?
Here's the Alvarez leads with a good left hook to the forehead, well, to the temple. Then Cintron comes back with that beautiful jab. Well, that's again, you see the hook, followed by a great right hand to the top of the head. But those shots landed high on Cintron's head, so you take them better. Left hook followed by a straight right hand, and the right hand was partially blocked.
But it moved Cintron back, boy. That's what I mean about heavy-handed. It moved his whole body.
Yes, it did. He is definitely a very heavy-handed puncher, that Alvarez.
Well, according to the CompuBox numbers, Cintron threw almost twice as many punches as Alvarez in that round, 50 to 26. Landed four. As we begin round number two, scheduled for 12, Alvarez in the white, Cintron in the black.
And we expected Alvarez to be much more economical with his land reach. He's going to land a lot more punches in comparison to what he throws than his current Cintron.
All right, so Roy, feeling out first round for both fighters. So what's the adjustment that Alvarez will now try to enact in round number two?
Well, now he'll start trying to make more contact with Cintron to see how Cintron really takes his big punches. He's going around, taking his time. He don't want to rush nothing because he knows Cintron has the experience factor as a professional, and Cintron is a very good puncher.
All right, so on the flip side, let's go the other way now. Cintron got a sense of Alvarez's hand speed, whatever. What adjustment or what plan does he try to enact here in round two?
Well, he's throwing his jab, which is a great idea, but what he has to do at this point is get some respect. Right now, Alvarez has no respect for Cintron's power, so he needs to land a good shot. You see that? Alvarez is all out with his shots because he doesn't respect Cintron's power right now. Cintron needs to land a big shot to establish some respect.
Alvarez goes to the body and backs up Cintron.
One of the interesting things about Alvarez, and there are several, is that it's not easy to really describe his style. He starts out boxing on the perimeter. He can move in if he senses his guy is hurt and become the aggressor, Roy. How would you describe his style?
He's a great all-around fighter. He can fight from the outside. He can fight in close. You don't find many young fighters who can do that, but he did just get caught with a good check hook a few seconds ago that made him back up and respect Cintron a little bit. Now he's got a little bit more respect when he's attacking. He's not attacking just all out with his hands anywhere like he was.
He's a good puncher boxer as opposed to a boxer puncher. He's taking a punch first.
Exactly.
Coach, with 1 minute to go here in round number two. Alvarez digs in with a combo.
The other good thing for Cintron is the shot that he really landed was a left hook, and I think his straight right hand used to be his best punch, so maybe he's still saving that, like that.
Cintron has mentioned that it's hard for him to keep the weight up In other words, he made 147 pounds no problem. And now at junior middleweight, the struggle is not to make the weight, it's to keep it the weight on him because he's naturally not that big.
And you can just about be assured that Alvarez is somewhere close to the 170 range right now.
Yeah, you can see it, a big, thick guy for his height. Upper body.
Strong with that combination. Jab slips through.
10 seconds, yes, sir.
See, Cintron doesn't commit to that right hand anymore like he used to.
There's the bell to end round two.
Put the right hand. There you go. All right. Okay. Now listen. You're showing up a little bit too much respect now, okay? Fuck this kid, man. We gotta go get him now, okay? Okay? We gotta put a little bit more pressure on him.
You gotta work your jab.
Hay que volver.
Step on the guard open. If you're dead, you gotta get him here.
Almost second. Fuera.
So he gets set for the start of round number three between Canelo Alvarez and Kermit Cintron. No knockdowns in the fight. Well, I like what Ronnie Shields said, Roy. You're showing him too much respect. Look, you're in Mexico. Alvarez has got the belt. He's the money guy. I mean, you've got to step it up. He threw 46 jabs in the last round, but you've got to start putting some pressure on him or else it's going to be more of the same.
He said the same thing that I was saying. You got to establish some respect at some point. If you don't make this kid respect you and go out and act like you want to take his title, you're not going to win the fight.
I think one of the problems is Alvarez is the better counterpuncher. You saw in the last round, Cintron throw a jab, Alvarez weave it and make him pay. And I think that's keeping Cintron's power hand at home, right? Through a right hand.
Yeah, but I don't like that right hand.
Yeah,
it's not as powerful as it used to be. You know, it used to be when Cintron threw the right hand, you know, it was going to be some problems if it landed.
Right.
This right hand he's throwing tonight is not going to be any problems if it lands.
Tentative because he's scared of what's coming back at him?
No, he's just not committing to it anymore. He's committing to throwing more punches now. He tried to become more of a boxer instead of a puncher. So he doesn't sit down on the right hand like he used to do.
He used to sit down on right hands, and then guys used to sit down and lie down.
You better believe it. See, like that. That's a good hook, but the hook was the better punch of the combination.
And it's Alvarez applying the pressure, moving Cintron back. Good left hook inside. Caught Cintron. Right hand glances to the top of the head.
At one point in his career, Cintron posed a real problem for anyone because of the relatively big size for a welterweight. The athleticism, the good hand speed, the excellent punching power. There was no easy way to beat him.
No, it wasn't. It was a big problem.
It's HBO's Boxing After Dark. Canelo Alvarez, Kermit Cintron in round number three. Alvarez defending his junior middleweight title. Bob Papa, Roy Jones, Max Kellerman. Ringside in Cincinnati earlier tonight. Adrian Broner victorious to win a portion of the junior lightweight belt. Live here in Cincinnati. He took care of Martin Rodriguez in the third round.
At this point, though, as Roy, as you mentioned, unless Cintron lands something like he means it, it looks as though, especially in light of recent performances, the Cintron that we used to know welterweight isn't here anymore.
No, he's not, because he's letting Alvarez close the door now, which means he's allowing Alvarez to get too close to him because Alvarez does not fear his power, and that's not a good sign for him.
That will just increase the confidence level of Alvarez, right?
That's basically what's happening right now.
10 seconds.
Because he's closed the distance, his counters are working better. He caught him with a good counter right hand over the top of the jab.
You gotta take a chance. And look, I'm telling you, man, you gotta hit this guy in the body. You got to get close enough to go to this
guy. Tune in Friday,
okay?
December 2nd at 9 p.m. for 24/7 overtime. Okay? Cota Margarito, Jim Lampley, Max Kellerman, and Emmanuel Stewart will put the finishing touches on 24/7 with the help of some familiar faces from the series. On Saturday, tune into HBO Zone at 5 p.m. for Fight Day Now, a one-hour special packed with guests, features, and in-depth analysis to prepare you for that night's mega matchup. It's all part of the countdown toward the long-awaited rematch between Miguel Cotto and Antonio Margarito, coming to you next Saturday night on HBO pay-per-view. And we begin round number four between Alvarez and Cintron. Let's check in with our unofficial ringside scorer, Harold Letterman.
Okay, Bob, I got a two rounds to one, 29-28, Canelo Alvarez. You know, in round one, Cintron outworked him, but Canelo did more damage. I mean, there's no question, landing the hardest shots. Round two, Kermit Cintron threw a ton more punches, and Canelo just seemed to feel him out, didn't do a heck of a lot. Round three, Canelo started to come forward with that lead right hand and that left hook he throws all the time. I thought Canelo won round three, 2-1, Canelo Alvarez. By the way, we're going to hear the official scores after round four.
All right, thanks, Harold. Open scoring in Mexico City.
Bro, you think Canelo's doing enough considering how passively Cintron is fighting?
He's really not doing enough right now, but it seems as though they, kind of like we saw in his last fight, he's kind of waiting to wear Cintron down. You see him throwing a hook to the head, hook to the body there. He's trying to wear Cintron down, close the distance, and the more he closes the distance, the more he'll be able to hit Cintron. So I don't think he's trying to waste his punches early.
Yeah, for a 21-year-old who can punch, he's very patient.
Very, very patient.
And he's using that left hook to the body very effectively here in this round.
And Cintron's corner told him to go to the body. He hasn't gone to the body yet, but Alvarez is doing beautiful body work right here.
Cintron's pumping out jabs. Alvarez is pumping out hooks and straight right hands. Lead right from Cintron, right hand. Hurts Cintron and down he goes. Seventh time Cintron's been down in his career. Alvarez looking to finish it here in the fourth. That's a slip. That is not a knockdown. That's a slip. They got tangled up. Benefit Cintron. At least I think so. Cintron's going straight back, and that's why that right hand landed.
Well, because he was such a powerful puncher, guys didn't take a chance of counting his left jab much because they were afraid of the right hand. But now Alvarez has no fear of the right hand at all.
Good left.
Countering the jab at will.
And Cintron hurt at the end of the round as well. Blood coming from his nose. Another left hand has hurt Cintron.
And it looks like he may be done.
For a guy who looks like he didn't want to go on after that first knockdown, though, Roy, he was throwing some hard shots back.
Oh, he was gambling.
Take a deep breath. You know where you are?
Just keep up with that.
Okay. No. Listen to me. Are you okay? Yeah, listen. Okay, look.
Grab his legs. Come on.
Look. Box, okay?
He's the Alvarez counting the jab with a jab of his own. Then you see a corner on the top of the jab with a straight right hand. This is what guys used to be afraid to do to Kermit Cintron because they was worried about his right hand.
And Cintron got lucky that that bell rang because he was hurt badly at the end of the round as well
and caught up in the ropes.
He didn't get lucky. Another one just rolled.
Well, can Alvarez finish the show here with a hurt Cintron in front of him?
See that right there? Anytime you can't get out of the way of a guy counting your jab, you got bad problems.
Cintron's throwing hard shots back, but he
there
lets
you go.
There's a combination.
That's a Cintron we used to look for.
But then Cintron he gets right.
Hit. Yeah, and he looks like he lacks coordination when he gets hit with a shot.
He's getting hit with those right hands in the temple area. It looks like he's losing his balance.
Since that first knockdown, he just looks like he's ready to fall.
The problem
he does counter with a right hand, though, and then a left.
That might have been an old Kermit Cintron right here.
Yeah.
But the problem is he can't get out the way of the right hand over the top of his own jab. Alvarez hits him on the top like that anytime he gets ready.
Well, he just keeps going straight back.
And you can't get away from the right hand like that.
Well, he just showed he has the power to bother Alvarez. Will he go back to that power shot now?
He has no other choice. He seems like a guy that's just out of it tonight. He doesn't really seem to be in it tonight. He's not sharp. He's lethargic. He's not ready. He's got us like just not on point tonight.
Well, at 32 and a former welterweight champion, he needs a big performance tonight, not to be off point.
And he doesn't seem to be on point tonight at all.
Alvarez digs in with some power shots.
Alvarez must have shot a puncher.
Max, that's one of the fun things, too, though, about watching Alvarez. He gets hit just enough to make it fun.
Yep. He may one day be a dominant fighter, but at this point, only 21. He's a fun fighter to watch because of that, what you mentioned. Meanwhile, at this point in the fight, Cintron seems to be throwing back in spite of himself.
Just throw a ball, but it seems like he's dead tired, Max.
Yeah. Like he's almost surprised when he does land a punch and bother Alvarez.
Yeah, he seems like he's dead tired. Like that.
Good combination by Alvarez. And the referee, Hector Afu, has stopped it.
Well, Cintron was throwing back, but he was taking a beating. And I didn't love his reaction to a lot of those shots.
I didn't either. Like I said, just didn't seem old tonight. Wasn't sharp at all. Wasn't responding quick enough to the punches.
So Canelo Alvarez gets win number 39 in his 29th stoppage as he overpowers Kermit Cintron. In that last round, according to CompuBox, Alvarez landed 28 of 50. 23 of those connects were power shots to Cintron's 11 of 66. Just never felt like Cintron had his legs under him after taking those power shots from Alvarez. Even though he was able to get some shots back on Alvarez, Roy, it never seemed to do the kind of damage that he needed to do.
A lot of times when a guy moves up in weight and he doesn't really have to hold his weight up, or he has to work to gain the weight, it's bad for him because he's fighting a guy who's coming down to that weight. So if you're coming up, meet the guy who's coming down. At the fight night, Canelo probably has 15 pounds on Cintron right now.
Well, he's a big draw in Mexico City, throughout Mexico. And I guess, Max, we talked about the whole Chavez sort of backdrop, Chavez Jr. Alvarez is now held serve.
Exactly right, and they're going back and forth. And even though they have different promotional outfits, Canelo with Golden Boy and Chavez Jr. with Top Rank, and sometimes those two organizations aren't in a rush to do business together. I think in this case, Roy, they're going to have to do some business together before too long.
And they better get in a rush to do it before somebody else intervenes and causes problems.
Right. Their flaws are part of what makes them interesting.
There you go. That was a good right hook to the body by Kermit Cintron. But right as you see, Alvarez comes right back over the top of that same right hand that he'd been smashed with all night long. There's another one. Straight right hand, right on the button. No way in the world Cintron's going to keep taking that right hand. Over and over and over again, Alvarez landed that straight right. Right here you see behind Cintron's double jab right hand, hook, straight right hand over the top again. Followed by a body shot and another right hand to the back of the head. And the ref has seen enough because of the way Cintron was reacting to it.
Roy, how does Canelo hide that right hand? Why is he able to land it like that?
Well, he's hiding it behind his left hook. He's throwing a left hook and turning his shoulder up very high so you can't see the right hand coming. But for some reason, Cintron couldn't have seen it coming tonight anyway. He just wasn't ready to defend it over the top of his jab. See right there, he tried to turn, but he turned too late.
And just time and time again, Alvarez was able to zero in with that right hand and take a look at it again. And
you see how Alvarez blocked his right hand? Cintron was trying to roll Alvarez's right hand with his left hand down, and he just could not roll
it. Damas y caballeros, 2 minutos 53 segundos del quinto asalto. El referee para la pelea para el ganador por knockout técnico. The end comes 2 minutes 53 seconds. Round number 5. Referee Hector Afu calls a halt to the bout for your winner by TKO victory. Se mantiene el invicto campeón CMB Super Welter. And still the undefeated WBC light middleweight champion of the world, Saul Canelo.
So it's the third defense of his junior middleweight belt. 253 of round number 5. We take a look at the total punches. Alvarez landed at 37%. 79 of 215. Cintron used the jab throughout the course of the night. 187 of his 285 punches thrown were jabs. He landed his total punches at 14%. And Alvarez was able to break him down by using his power shots. 62 of 141, 44%. He landed 23 power shots of 39 in the final round to finish him off, and Cintron could not deal with that power. 19 of 98 for 19% over the balance of the fight. And we take a look at the punch zone as well. And to the left, punches landed on Alvarez, the 41 punches. Cintron did not do enough to attack the body. Whereas Cintron landed 63 to the head, but he did land some good body shots. 16 connects to the body of his total 79. So Canelo Alvarez victorious in Mexico. Max Kellerman is standing by with the victorious Alvarez and HBO translator Jerry Olaya.
Canelo, congratulations on a dominant win. What was the game plan?
Canelo, felicidades, una gran victoria, dominante victoria. ¿Cuál era tu plan de ataque?
Plaza de Toros, México.
Señor, the plan was not to despair. And
having some audio problems, it sounds like. Canelo, for a 21-year-old with a big punch, you're very patient. Why?
Tiene 21 años con gran pegada y eres muy paciente. ¿Por qué?
No los escucho.
Okay. Thanks, Canelo, for trying it anyway. We got him. We got him. Canelo, congratulations on a dominant performance. What was the game plan?
Felicidades, Canelo, en una pelea en la cual dominaste. ¿Cuál fue tu plan de ataque?
Bueno, no desesperarnos. Desde un principio lo dijimos. Creo que hicimos el trabajo muy bien hecho y eso fue lo que nos resultó.
Don't despair, as we said from the beginning. I think we did a very good job and that was a good result.
Can you talk about your patience? You're a young fighter with a big punch, but you're very patient.
Eres un boxeador joven con gran pegada, pero eres muy paciente. Háblanos de eso. Muy tranquilo.
Así era un peleador muy fuerte, pero nosotros sabíamos de eso, nos preparamos muy bien. Hicimos la pelea inteligente, hicimos las cosas como me dijeron la esquina y fue fue como ganamos la pelea.
He's a very strong fighter. We prepared intelligently. We followed the instructions from the corner, and that's how we ended up winning the fight.
What were the instructions from the corner?
¿Cuáles eran las instrucciones de la esquina?
Bueno, no desesperarnos, llevarlo poco a poco. Es un peleador muy experimentado y sabe lo que hace arriba del ring. Y pues tratamos de hacer las cosas con calma, ir dominando de poco a poco.
Don't despair, do things slowly, round by round, because he's a very qualified fighter. And so that's what we did, round by round.
Canelo, when he got up from the first knockdown, he was throwing some hard shots back at you. Did you feel his power at that point?
Cuando se levantó de la caída, ¿tú sentías que él sentía tu pegada?
Sí, así es. Ahí fue cuando sentí que también resentía él. Entonces se levantó ya muy mareado. El siguiente round nada más era cuestión de tiempo.
You know, I felt that he did feel my power, and I thought it was just a matter of time. And the next round is when it happened.
What's next for you, Canelo? What do you want to happen? Only 21 years old, already a big star. What is in your plans for the near future?
Canelo, ¿qué quieres en tus planes en el futuro próximo? Tienes 21 años y eres una estrella. ¿Qué quieres?
El próximo año queremos a los mejores. Queremos a Mayweather en mayo.
Next year we want the best. We want Mayweather in May.
Vámonos.
That certainly is the big payday. But what makes you think you're ready for the pound-for-pound best fighter in the world?
Es una pelea de mucho dinero, sin duda. Pero ¿qué te hace sentir que te sientes listo para pelear contra el número uno libra por libra?
No, independientemente del dinero, eso no es lo que queremos. Queremos demostrar que somos los mejores del mundo. Él es el mejor libra por libra y lo queremos.
Apart from the money, that doesn't matter. We want to fight the best in the world. He's the best pound for pound, and that's what we want. We want to fight him.
Thanks, Canelo. Appreciate it. Tremendous performance.
Felicidades, Canelo. Gran rendimiento. Felicidades.
Gracias a todos.
Eso. Gracias, campeón.
All right, Max. So Canelo Alvarez comes away with the victory tonight. Your impressions of what you saw out of Alvarez, as well as what you saw out of Adrian Broner tonight here in Cincinnati.
Listen, everyone on the card tonight had the right guys in front of them, and boxing is matchmaking. Even guys like Mayweather and Pacquiao, when they look that good, it's matchmaking. Even the great Roy Jones, although sometimes Roy could pull it off even with a really good guy in front of him. Canelo is a really good fighter. I like watching him fight. Who doesn't? He brings action. He throws hard shots. He's looking to do damage. He's got solid boxing skills for a 21-year-old. The junior middleweight division is chock full of interesting matchups, especially for a guy like Canelo. We showed you the graphic. Miguel Cotto, Antonio Margarito, Bundridge, Kirkland, but still Angulo. Who wouldn't want to see any of these fights? So that when a fighter calls out Mayweather because he wants the best and says that money doesn't matter, to me it seems that that's the opposite. He's calling out Mayweather because he wants the money, and fighting the best is not as important. If it were, he would start to, Golden Boy, his promoter, would start to match him up with these good but not great but action-packed junior middleweight tigers that they have in this division.
All right, well, we'll see what's next for Canelo Alvarez. Good job as always. Max, Roy, send it over to you. Look, we saw the youngest reigning champion, and now with Broner winning a title, he's the second youngest reigning champion in the world. I mean, look, they're belts. They got a piece of some belt. They're not arguably the best guys necessarily in their division at this point. And as Max pointed out, they had the right guys in front of them. But your thoughts on what you saw out of Adrian Broner this evening, taking part in Martin Rodriguez and then Canelo Alvarez?
Well, I kind of disagree about Broner. I think he is one of the elite 130-pounders in the world today. So I think he may be at the top of his class. They just haven't given him the credibility yet because he hasn't had those big-named opponents in front of him yet. With Canelo Alvarez, I almost said it looked like Pacquiao just got bigger, because he's a guy who packs a heck of a punch, and now he's asking for Floyd Mayweather. I like Alvarez. I like his power. I like his patience. He just seems like an older fighter when he fights. He's a guy that you can tell grew up boxing. He's not a guy who just came to this game. He grew up with the sport in him. You could tell by the way he reacts in the ring, how patient he is against a good guy, a guy that has more experience than him, actually. So I can't wait to see whatever his future holds, because I'm sure it'll be bright, and I'm sure it'll be definitely interesting.
Well, the key on tonight's HBO Boxing After Dark, youth would be served, and Canelo Alvarez makes the third defense of his championship, and Adrian Broner gets a piece of a championship in the 130-pound weight class with an impressive performance against Martin Rodriguez. If you missed any of tonight's telecast, you can catch it in its entirety at the dates and times listed below. And starting Sunday, watch tonight's fights anytime, anywhere on HBO Go. The streaming service available on your computer, iPad, iPhone, and Android. Register now at HBOGo.com. And remember to visit our HBO Boxing Facebook page and join the conversation on our HBO Boxing Twitter feed. Next Friday night, December the 2nd at 9 p.m., it's 24-7 overtime. Cota Margarito, Jim Lampley, Max Kellerman, and Emmanuel Stewart will be on hand to talk about Saturday's big fight with the help of some familiar faces from the series. For more Cota Margarito programming, tune in to HBO Zone on Saturday at 5 p.m. for Fight Day Now, a one-hour special packed with guests, features, and in-depth analysis. It's all part of the countdown toward that night's long-awaited rematch between Miguel Cotto and Antonio Margarito on HBO Pay-Per-View. Next on HBO, make sure you stay tuned for 24-7 Cotto Margarito, followed by Boardwalk Empire. So for our entire HBO crew, I'm Bob Papa saying so long from the Queen City, Cincinnati, Ohio.
This has been a presentation of HBO Sports.